for this.
It's Liam Mouse Vlog, Liam Mouse Vlog, it's Liam Mouse's Vlog.
Good morning. I'll tell you what, I slept like a brick inside a rock inside a hibernating bear. No little kitties to jump up on the bed to wake me up. Nobody making noise. No traffic. People on the street screaming their heads off. No snoring. Oh my god, I was like dead to the world. I fell asleep at like 11 and my mom woke me up at 10 knocking on the little connector door thingy because I was still out. I slept through my alarm. My alarm is set to go off 5 times at 10 minute increments or something. I slept through it 5 times. That's how dead to the world I was. But I got plenty of sleep. I feel really good and rested, and now I'm trying to get my makeup done here so that we can get going. We're going to St. Catherine's. So I will catch up with you then. I'm loading up all my shit to take it down to the car. Ugh. And it is a lot of shit. I'm gonna have to make another trip. Oh my god. We found a full service gas station. I didn't know this still existed except for in like towns of 5 people in the United States and, you know, Virginia. And we're marveling over how beautiful the Canadian money is. But yeah, you can see through it. It's very cool. So it's very pretty. And we're weird. We're touristy Americans, all right? Give us a break. I'm taking mom to a surprise destination. She doesn't know where we're going. I think she'll like it. And my GPS keeps saying things to me in kilometers, which is just weird. This is obviously land to grow things, because like all we see is just all this like growing land and trees and vineyards and bushes, and mom thinks that I can't pay attention to the road and talk to a camera at the same time. This is, yes, in abundance, this is the farming and whatever area, apparently. So it's kind of cool, and everyone has their these ginormous, like, I'm a rich snooty pants houses. We're surrounded by vineyards! Vineyards everywhere! Oh my god, come on.
In 800 meters, turn left.
Okay.
Okay.
Do you have your meter stick? How big is a meter? I don't know. No, no, oh my god. By the time you get the book out, oh my god, you're gonna find out. Oh, okay. Mom leans forward. I'm gonna find out how big a meter is. It's like I'm driving, I'm like 2 seconds away from turning.
Of course I can't find the bay.
Oh my god.
Miles and kilometers.
Alright, fine, co-pilot. What's a meter compared to a mile or kilometer or whatever? Oh my god, stop texting me! Steve! Why? I'm trying to follow this GPS thing.
All right, a meter. Well, it doesn't tell. It's
continue straight.
A meter is 3.3 feet. Does that help you?
It's about a yard.
Okay, yeah.
So a meter is about a yard.
Yeah.
Okay, I can remember that. We have a yardstick!
Yeah!
Okay,
yeah.
We can do this. We have a yardstick.
I can just break it off 3 times. There you go.
Okay, so we are here.
Can I open my eyes now?
Yes, you can open your eyes.
Oh, isn't this pretty? Ooh. Oh my goodness, we got a cannon.
Do you know where we are?
No idea.
We're at Fort George.
All right, Fort George.
It's a historical fort.
Whoa!
Mom likes historical places.
Yeah.
So I thought you might like this.
Oh, I love it. Now.
Yes, I can tell by your oozing enthusiasm.
Well, when I get out and look at it, it's on Niagara on the Lake, right?
Oh my god, she has to look in the tour book because just getting out and looking isn't the same.
Oh, it isn't, but I was going to read about Fort George.
Well, how about we go over there and learn about Fort George, like while we're actually here? Oh, let's sit in the car in the parking lot of Fort George and read the tour book to learn about Fort George. That's a good idea.
Oh, it's funny. Okay, let's go.
today I was prepared and wore long sleeves. And it's nice.
Yeah.
So, here I am in long sleeves with my sleeves rolled up because it's actually kind of hot.
Oh, I love these trees. Look at the bark on these.
I know.
Wow.
It almost looks fake.
Those
it
are
looks
gorgeous.
Painted. This is very pretty. Le historique national du Canada. I don't know French. Oh my god, the bees that are in the grassy. Oh god, that was scary. There were like so many bees just like on the flowers and like in the grass. Ew. I'm really lucky. I didn't get stung. The scenery is magnificent.
Yes, yes.
I thought you might like it.
I do.
I'm sorry we can't go in without paying, but this is free fun. I've discovered a path up to the fort, and I'm going to infiltrate the fort. I'm going to go up to one of these little holes and film through it and take a picture, because I can. I can see the fort from the inside. I'm a rebel. Look at the trench. See what it looks like. Ooh, so many flying things, oh dear.
Ooh, there's so many things with the wings and
I'm trying to find a spot that's actually like not filled with insects. I've infiltrated the fort, run! I hope not, with their muskets and their mounty horses and stuff. Look at that, just the broad expanse. Fort George! Done being stupid. So we found this nice little pine cone we're taking as a souvenir, because it's very pretty and it's the only one we saw around. So this is the Fort George pine cone we're gonna take. And we found this tea room earlier, okay? Where we're gonna go have high tea as soon as we're finished with our escapades up here. And Mom said she went in and asked the lady about high tea. And when she asked what was on the menu, Mom says that the lady said,
"We don't have spam."
That they don't serve spam. And that's okay because I don't like spam. My GPS is still on my phone. My phone's in my back pocket and my phone just was like, "Head southwest." I'm like, my ass just told us to go southwest.
500 meters, continue onto Niagara Parkway.
So yes, Mom and I just agreed that the only way we could actually tolerate the GPS, in Mom's words, was if we had a very sexy British man, and I said like Benedict Cumberbatch, and she's like, "Oh yes, I can listen to him for hours," and I fully agree with this. Who else?
Guy on the Geico commercial, but I don't know who he is.
The guy on the Geico commercial, the voice of the gecko?
Meters, turn right onto East and West Line.
I can see it. I mean, it's not really a gecko. They actually do have different voices you can get for the GPS units.
Oh.
I have it on my phone, so I can't do it. I might be able to like find something. But for the actual ones that are in the cars,
continue on East and West Line for 8 kilometers.
They actually do have different ones you can pick, like they have an Australian guy British. Yeah, so you can change them on those, but. Well, we're in St. Catharines now, and I've been here a couple of times, actually. I actually vlogged it. It was part of the 2013 stuff that you guys didn't see, but yeah, we won't get into why I was up here or what I was doing, but it was fun. There's a little goose crossing sign. Isn't it nice?
Seagulls! Seagulls!
They don't want me to chase them.
I'm running.
Hey, Mr. Seagull! Just want to say hi!
Okay, this, I could live here. I could deal with seeing this every day.
Hi.
shoes off because it feels nice. I'm gonna roll my pants up and see what the water's like.
On the shell, baby. Cold?
Yeah.
I bet.
It's nice though. Oh my gosh. I feel like a little kid. It's like, I'm in the water. I'm in the water. So blue. Sand is warm. Feels nice. I found geese. It's so just... I don't know, it's quiet and it's peaceful.
I love the songbirdies. Sing away. You're so lucky to be a Canadian birdie.
I second that. Any Canadian anything is lucky to be a Canadian anything. Except for Canadian bacon, because it's dead and you eat it. But whatever. My mom just said I'm a good driver. And she doesn't feel nervous riding with me. Suck on it, Derek. We are going to High Tea at this, what's the name of it?
Queen Charlotte.
Queen Charlotte something. Tea room. So we're about 5 minutes away and we are going for high tea for our scones and our sandwiches and our tea. It's 2:40. So we will very much enjoy that. And one of the main things we wanted to do while up here was have the high tea, because we've never had high tea. Well, Mom did, but I haven't. So we're looking forward to sharing high tea, and I can stop saying high tea now. High tea! Well, here we are, the Queen Charlotte Tea Room and British restaurant. Queen Charlotte Tea Room. How fun. Is this Queen Charlotte? I'm assuming it is. Everyone's looking at me funny because I have my camera. Oh my.
Oh, okay.
Look at the pretty little teacups. The thing with the sugar cubes. Oh, it's neat.
Don't forget to use your strainer because it's loose leaf tea.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
And this must be what a tea cozy is.
Yeah.
I've heard people say tea cozy and I'm like, what the hell's a tea cozy? This must be a tea cozy, this little floofy thing.
No.
Because it's hot. Ooh, it smells caramely. What did we get? Scottish caramel? Okay. It smells really good. Very, very hot. Mm-hmm. I'm just gonna wait a second.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna do like a sippy thing, like just sort of, because it's so hot. Oh, that's good.
That is very good.
Okay, I'm determined now. I want a teapot with like real tea. I've been wanting one forever. Every time we go to Teavana, I was like, I want this teapot. And it was only $60. I never ever got it. But I've always wanted one.
Yeah.
So I can actually get the real, like, the leaf tea, like the like this.
Hmm.
Have good stuff rather than the bag Walmart crap.
Yeah.
I will.
The tea.
It's very, very good. Thank you.
It's very good.
Okay. So we have egg sandwiches. They have a little bit of honey Dijon and some alfalfa sprouts, the onion ones, and then these ham sandwiches with a little bit of Branston pickle in them as well, and cucumber cream cheese, plain scones, strawberry preserves, and this is Devonshire cream, so it's pure Devonshire cream. We
oh
don't mix
my.
It
awesome.
With any whipping cream or anything, okay?
Great.
And then when you finish that, we'll bring you dessert.
All right, thank you.
Okay,
fun!
See how many we've got.
These sandwiches are fantastic.
Yeah.
I feel so dainty. With the pinky. I'm going to try this Devonshire cream on this thing.
Good.
I never want to eat regular food again. I want to have tea
and scones with definite cream and little light, delicate sandwiches for the rest of my life.
I've had 3 cups of this tea, and Mom and I are starting to feel the effects of it. We're feeling very sleepy and like mellow and calm. But yeah, we're like getting very mellowed out and like sleepy from the calming effects of the tea. And we're like, crap, we have to drive now home. Well, I do.
The tradition of high tea. In England in the 1700s, there were 2 main meals of the day, breakfast and dinner. Dinner was served very late in the evening, so it was a long time between meals. The Duchess of Bedford complained about a sinking feeling in the late afternoon, so she invented the afternoon tea. She would invite friends to join her for tea at 5 p.m. Soon, other hostesses copied her idea. Afternoon tea consisted of small crustless sandwiches, regional pastries, jam and scones. The emphasis was on presentation and conversation. And that is the history of high tea.
So what do we have here?
This is chocolate fudge cake.
Okay.
And then we have orange cake here.
Ooh.
And that's really light and refreshing. Okay. This is almost like having trifle in a cake. It's a cookie base. Ooh. It has custard and sponge in it and then cream on the top.
That sounds awesome.
And they're done with real cream. So.
Very nice. There
you go.
Great.
Enjoy.
Thank you.
So much sugar. So much for swearing off sugar. It's a good thing I only ate vegetables yesterday. Wow! That puts American cake to shame. Dang, that is good. I couldn't resist getting my own tea. I got my own tea of the one that we had, actually. It was the Scottish caramel toffee. So, I have my own tea. So good, so relaxing, and so soothing. And so yummy! I had 4 cups, and now I gotta drive back to Ohio. Ha! So we're about to go back across the border.
Okay.
I booked my tattoo appointment with Dennis for August, and the guy was very surprised that I wanted to book that far ahead, and I'm just like, that's what we do in the States. So, but he was cool, so I got dibs on that guy, because he was cool. And yeah, we're going and waiting at customs now. We're gonna be here for quite some time, and don't yell at me for my seatbelt, because I had to jump back and get my purse to get my passport out. That's why my seatbelt is not on.
As well as forward, and it's great.
Mm-hmm. I'm having problems. Could you move my purse? Just grab it and move it for me.
Where is it?
It's right here. You got your hand on it. Pick it up.
This whole big shit thing is a purse.
Yes, the whole big shitting thing is a purse.
Look at mine. I mean, you know, comparison.
Well, I carry much more stuff than you do. Yeah,
obviously.
Mom's all high from the high tea, and she can't find her passport. She just had it. I saw it in your hand. There it is. All right, now keep it in your hand.
My mitt.
Your mitt. That's what.
This is ridiculous.
We're keep saying that we're high from the high seas. Like, what they put in the tea?
Scottish cardinal. Wow. That's all I can say.
Oh, Lord. Yeah, I had about 4 cups of that shit, and I'm like.
Oh, God. What the hell did they put in that?
We pulled up to the freaking thing. We're both giggling our asses off. And I have to hand the guy our passports, and we're both like, like giggling.
Don't ever have a tea, Queen Charlotte.
Not before you have to go across the border, that's for sure. He's like, how do you ladies know each other? I'm like, she's my mom. This dingbat that's giggling in the passenger seat is my mom. All right, we are back in the United States of America, so...
Yes, where there's no high tea.
No high tea. No. We might as well have just smoked a joint. I'm just saying. The dope, Mom.
A dope. Yep, I'm a dope. What happened to my Kleenex box? I need a Kleenex. I gotta.
Why, do you want a snack?
Yep.
They tore down the overpass over 90. Derek's the only one who knows what I'm saying. That and people who live in Buffalo. But that's really strange.
we're on 90, right where, you know, before where I used to live in Cheektowaga there. I can't remember how to get to the Ambets. All right, we're taking the Walden Avenue exit because, change of plans, we're going to go to the Ambets. Mom and I always meant to go, and then she didn't come up again, and we never got there. So, we're going to go. Hey, we're at the Ambets where I always used to go.
It's so cool.
Feels like a vlog in Buffalo again. I forgot they played such bitchin' music here.
Aw. Oh, the high.
Those are pretty. Oh my goodness. Aw. They're cute. What size are they? 6. Oh. I'm size 8. My big ass feet wouldn't fit into those. Those are so cute though. Oh my goodness. This is weird. This is weird. This is weird. This is weird. It's like I'm living here again, except I'm not. Look at all the furniture they have compared to like what they used to. Whole dining room sets and lots of chairs. And God, they didn't have anywhere near this amount of furniture before. Bella's dress. I don't know why you can see it, but it's cute. I think it's cute. Oh God, there went my phone. Yeah. I don't know. This is cute. I think I'm gonna get it. Yay!
Oh, Bon Jovi.
Coming up on where I used to live.
Yeah.
And now that I no longer live there, I don't see the problem in feeling where and what it was. There's Edbrook Estates. It's where I used to live.
Now leasing.
Yeah. So those of you who are fans of my Buffalo vlogs, you'll probably recognize this area, but I mean, I didn't, and the speed bumps. I didn't ever show the sign Edgebrook Estates on video because I didn't want people to know where I lived. But yeah, this is it. So strange that I used to live here. Like, I would be home right now.
Yeah.
But I'm not. And for those of you who are big fans of my main channel videos, the What It's Like to Date a YouTuber video was shot right here at a picnic table that is not sitting there at the moment. And also the swing where Derek and I are holding hands when I said I have to get this on video is right there.
Well, for heaven's sake, I don't remember seeing this stuff.
Yep, on location. Mm-hmm. Oh, it's weird, it's weird, it's weird, it's weird. Yep, that was my building.
Yeah, this one right over here.
And I always used to park right there. Oh my gosh, it's so strange. Yeah, that was my porch.
Oh.
Right there with the three, looks like candles.
Yeah.
That was my porch.
Never been so happy to lose signal. Okay, here we go. We're gonna make the T-Rex jump. No, no, don't load, don't load, damn it! Well, I saw it for a second.
Finally home. Good night, Mom.